Hello and welcome to Model Train Fun. Today we are going to look at how to make a turnout digital so we can control it with a mobile station or the central station. In essence, we're going to look at a normal turnout, a curved turnout, but also the double slip. And what we're going to do is we're going to add a turnout mechanism and a decoder to these such that we can remote control them from the mobile station and the central station. This video is the first in a three-part series, and in this one here we're going to look at the turnout mechanism. The turnout mechanism is actually the little engine or the little mechanism that physically makes the turnout change and turn. From Märklin, the turnout mechanism actually comes in three different versions. I got two of them here. The oldest one here is the 74490, that's the original one. And I also got the newest one here, that's the 74492. If you have a 74491, which unfortunately I don't have, then please install it as the 74492. And do remember, whenever you're fiddling with the electronics and the tracks, always read the safety instructions, and do the installation with power off. Enjoy the video. Here we have the turnouts I want to look at today. We want to make them digital. So first we got here a regular turnout, which is a 24611. I got a curved turnout here, which is a 24672. I got a double slip, which is a 24624. Let's start with the normal turnout. That's this one here. Let's see if we can get it out of the box. So in the box, we actually have a manual and we have the turnout itself. If we look at the turnout here, before we made it digital, there's a little handle here we can use to shift the turnout. If we turn it upside down, we can see here the mechanism that makes it shift is actually behind this cover. Do not open that cover because evidently it's hard to put back on. When I shift it here, you can see there's a little tab down there right where my thumb is that disappears. Let me try here a little closer. See, it comes out and disappears. So basically, in order to make it digital, we need to have a little turnout mechanism that pushes this one and changes the turnout on top, right? If we look at the turnout, there's a couple of screw holes. There's a screw hole here and here for putting in the turnout mechanism. In addition to that, there is some tabs here, here, and here. Those we can use for mount the decoder. If we look at the curved turnout, it's basically similar to the normal turnout. Also comes with a manual. The curved turnout, as the normal turnout, has a little switch here we can use, where we can change the direction of the turnout. In the same way as before, there's a little tab, you see it came out right there, disappears, that the turnout mechanism needs to hook up to. And there's also a screw here and here for the turnout mechanism. But interestingly, the decoder will sit on the three tabs right out here, so we'll sit a little further away. If we look at the double slip, this one is different from the two turnouts. It does come with a manual as well, but you can see there's already some goodies inside, some connectors. If we turn it over, you can also see there's already a turnout mechanism mounted in here, and there's also a lantern as well mounted already, so that comes pre-mounted. If I take the wire off here, we see there is a wire for the turnout mechanism here, and then there's a wire for the lantern. If I look at it on this side, in the same way as the others, there's a little handle here that can be used to shifting the double switch. If I look at it on the back side, the hook is actually here for the turnout mechanism. You can see when I use the handle, that one will actually move back and forth. So the trick is to power the turnout mechanism such that it will do it instead of us using the handle here. Let's first look at the turnout mechanisms. They come in several different model numbers. This one here is the 74490. That's basically the original turnout mechanism. I also have a 74492. There's also a 74491. So you got 0, 91, and 92. The 91 and the 92 are basically updated versions of the original. And the big difference between the 91 and the 92 is the wire supplied such that you can connect them to actually a connector box. So the 91 has older style wires, while the 92 has newer style wires to be able to connect them to the connector box. Furthermore, for the manual, actually for the 74492, it says it has to be used with a switch mode power pack. I don't know if that's an absolute necessity, but if you're using the modern Märklin digital like Mobile Station 2 and the Central Station 3, it is a switched power pack, so there should be no issues there. All the mechanisms, turnout mechanisms, no matter what version they are, if it's the original 90, the 91, or the newest one here, the 92, can all be mounted in the three turnouts I showed you before. So the normal turnout, the curved turnout, and the double slip. As always, when you mount these type of things, read safety instructions first in the manual and make sure there's no power. So let's start by taking the original one here. See if we can get it out of the box. So there's a manual on how to install it. Some advice, I guess, here on how to use it. Then we have in here the mechanism itself. So this is the one that will change the little tab inside the turnout, and hence shift the direction of the turnout. There's a wire in here. There's a little bag with goodies. Let me open this one. So if we look at the bag, it comes with two screws I need to use for mounting the turnout mechanism. Then there is a couple of covers here. They are used to put on the turnout afterwards. They are to simulate a little turnout engine, prototypical turnout engine there. So the idea is basically after you add the turnout mechanism, you can remove the handle that you use for manually shifting, And then you can have these covers here to illustrate what would normally be there in a prototypical situation. In addition to that, there's three connectors here, so we could connect to the connector box. The connectors can basically just be connected to the wire, and then they be connected to the connector box. However, we are gonna use digital, so we're gonna use a decoder, so we don't need all of that. If we take the turnout here, and we look at how it fits inside, or the turnout mechanism fits inside, you can basically see there's a hole here, there's a hole in the other end as well. They basically just need to align with the pre-made holes for the screws. So you can see there's one there, and there's one over here. And then we need to make sure that it all aligns with the tab here, right? So again, if I shift here, you can see the tab disappears, and then now you can see it reappear. Make sure that the tab is out, because then we can basically just have the turnout mechanism snag the tag like this, and we can make sure that the screws align. So I see up here, I got it snagged on a little tab, I got it aligned here with the hole, and I got it aligned with the hole down there. So let's screw it together. And it actually fits really nicely. Once you there, you see the screw fits nicely in here, and then it will hold it safe. Add the other screw down here. Just make sure they're both tight. Now, when you got the turnout in or turnout mechanism in there, double check that it's actually hooked up correctly. Try and use the handle over here, and you can see it actually snags to the turnout mechanism. So all is good. So we mounted that one. If we look at the small plastic parts that came with the turnout mechanism, they can be used instead of the handle here, because in principle we don't need the handle anymore, as we're going to use the turnout mechanism. So the handle can basically just be gently pulled, and then it comes off, and then you got the handle by itself. Then you got two choices. You can put on the something that looks like a prototypical turnout engine. So you can basically, you see where these two tabs are, you can basically just click it in place here, like this. The hole here will be covered up by a lantern, if you choose to add one of those. The other choice you have is you got some covers, and remember there's a left and a right cover here, so you could use one of those and mount instead. So if I decided I don't want the turnout engine here, I can take this off, then I can mount a cover instead, and you basically just press it in place, and then you got a cover instead. So those are the two choices you have for the turnout. Me, I actually prefer how it originally is. I actually prefer to have the handle in there, so we can just quickly pop that back in again. And why do I prefer this? Because then I can change it manually, or I can change it digitally, depending on what my needs are. Now let's look at the updated turnout mechanism. This is the 74492. Let's get it out of the box. Also, this one comes with a manual. We have a little bag as well with the two screws and the cover. Oh, there's actually two covers in here if we look at it. So there's cover up there, cover here, and then the engine housing. If we look at the turnout mechanism itself, there's really no big difference. What the difference here is the wire that comes with it, which is this bright orange wire with a special connector for the modern type connector box. So if you have here the 74492 and the 74491, unfortunately I don't have the 91, but the big difference is basically the wire that comes with it. But in either case, we are not gonna need the wire. So let me mount this one. So first we get our screws out. The screws are the same size as before. We look at our turnout here. So this is our curved turnout. We turn it around. We look at the point down here, and we want to make sure that we can see the little tab. You see now the tab is there, now it's gone, now it's there, so we need to mount it when the tab is there. There's a screw hole here, and there's a screw hole there. So those are the two screw holes we need to use. So again, we need to make sure that the tab up here catches the little tab, and then we basically need to align the screw holes. So aligned here and align it there, and then we can basically just screw it together again, just like the other one. The dimensions are basically the same for the turnout mechanisms. I'm just lightly screwing that in place, and then let's make sure the other one also fits here. So we can screw this one in place. Okay, got both of them screwed in place. I'm just gonna make sure by using the handle that the turnout mechanism is actually connected and is moving. Okay, everything is fine. And finally, for the double slip, well, there was nothing to do related to turnout mechanism because there's already a turnout mechanism in here. So I'm happy it's mounted. I can double check that it actually moves when I move the handle. Everything looks good. So happy. I hope you enjoyed this video. The next video will be about how to install the decoder and how to set the address in the decoder. And the final video will be about how to control the turnouts from the central station and the mobile station too. If you like this video, please hit like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.